Hi, this video is about how to improve the quality of your live stream on YouTube. Do you sometimes lose your internet connection while live streaming on YouTube? Do you get blurry footage or experience delays? When going live on YouTube, you want the experience to go smoothly for yourself as well as for your viewers. Therefore, you need to test for any glitches that may happen before you tap the Go Live button on your phone. In this video, I discuss the speed requirements for live streaming, how to test the upload and download speeds, and provide several ways to improve the quality of your live stream on YouTube. Hi, my name is Herman Drost from drostdesigns.com. If this is your first time here, hit the subscribe button. If you've already subscribed, hit the bell icon to receive notifications on future videos. This channel is all about how to grow your audience on YouTube and generate traffic, leads, and sales on autopilot. At the end of the video, I'll share my experience of what happened when I lost my internet connection while live streaming from my iPhone. If your internet connection drops while watching a regular video, YouTube will lower the quality so you'll still be able to watch the video. With live stream videos, it depends on the quality of your own internet connection. So what are the speed requirements to live stream on YouTube? Your download speed is usually higher than your upload speed. So even if your download speed is high, it's not going to make much difference when you're live streaming. How is speed measured for a video? One of the biggest ones is the bitrate at which a video camera records. Bitrates are defined as megabits per second or MBPS. 1 megabyte per second equals 1,000 kilobytes per second.
Here's how to test your internet speed. Go to speedtest.net, click go. It's now showing my download speed. The download speed is 56.92 megabytes per second. That's showing my upload speed. The upload speed is 65.01 megabytes per second. So I'm good to go.
In a nutshell, the higher the bitrate of a video, the higher the quality of the video. If you're shooting at 1080p, the resolution is usually 1920 by 1080. The video bit range should be 3 to 6 megabits per second, or 3000 to 6000 kilobytes per second. If you're shooting in 720p, the resolution is usually 1280 by 720. The video bit range should be 1.5 to 4 megabytes per second, or 1,500 to 4,000 kilobytes per second. Most live streams are pushed out at 720p, so you need a bare minimum of at least 1.5 megabits per second. Live videos require a consistent internet connection and a consistent bit rate and quality. Your internet speed should match those requirements. If you're creating a live event from your desktop, you can choose the quality of your stream. Make sure you test before you start your live stream.
If you're doing Hangouts on air, you can adjust the bandwidth usage. Just tap this icon and it says video trouble, disable HD. It says you can adjust your video quality to limit your bandwidth usage. Check the system requirements for Hangouts. So operating systems, need Mac OS, Windows, Chrome, or Ubuntu. You need to use Google Chrome, Internet Explorer, or Safari. When you make the video calls, you need a broadband connection to the internet, USB web camera, a quad-core processor. How much bandwidth do you need? It says Hangouts changes how much bandwidth is used based on your network. Minimum bandwidth required is outbound, 300 kilobytes per second, and inbound, 300 kilobytes per second. And the ideal bandwidth for two-person video calls, outbound is 3.2 megabytes per second, and inbound, 2.6 megabytes per second. When you have group calls, the ideal bandwidth is outbound, 3.2 megabytes per second, inbound with 5 participants, 3.2 megabytes per second, inbound with 10 plus participants, 4 megabytes per second.
I'd like to share a case study with you when I lost my internet connection. I was ready to go live from my mobile phone, but I lost the Wi-Fi connection in my home office. I switched to using a personal hotspot on my phone and tested the speed using speedtest.net. The upload speed only showed 0.36 megabytes per second. I tested the live stream on my phone by setting the privacy settings to unlisted. The amazing thing is the live stream still worked. I didn't want to take the risk of having a bad connection or losing the connection while going live to people all over the world. Instead, I used a cellular connection from my iPhone. During the live stream, I continuously received pop-up messages saying I had a bad connection or poor connection. I asked the participants if they could hear and see me during the live stream. The answer was a resounding yes. So what's the lesson here? You can live stream from your mobile phone even if you have a poor or bad connection. But to be on the safe side, use the fastest upload speed that you can get. Here are some important tips to improve the quality of your live streams on YouTube. If you temporarily lose your internet connection while live streaming on YouTube, wait a few seconds because you might reconnect. You'll then be able to continue with your original live stream. Do a dry run by selecting unlisted from your privacy settings. If you lose the Wi-Fi connection in your home or office, like I did, use a cellular data connection from your mobile phone. If you experience any delays while broadcasting, pause after you finish talking so you give the attendees time to respond. Remove any devices that are consuming bandwidth so you don't experience any interruptions. If you're live streaming from your computer, reboot your computer before you go live. Let me ask you a question. Have you ever experienced any lost connections while going live on YouTube? Please share your experience in the comments below. I'd love to read them. Click the card icon to download my mobile live stream checklist for beginners. You'll learn the secrets to mobile live streaming on YouTube. If you want to learn how to grow your audience on YouTube and generate views and subscribers on autopilot, click the subscribe button below and check out the related videos. I'll see you in the next video.